It must have been one heck of a pep talk you gave to those Hawkeyes. I just wanted to start it off.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, that was a rough game. That was frustrating. Of course, it's like the scheduling gods were in my favor. You know, our bye week, Hawks come up here, and you know, obviously they're frustrated. They want to put forth a better effort. Big Ten game on the road, a huge game for both teams, and just not get the outcome they wanted was frustrating for them. But you know, as now just a fan, you know, it was frustrating for me to watch as well.
How hard is it to be a fan and watch your team go down like
well,
that?
Well, it's hard. I mean, obviously you want to be out there and do what you can do, but you know, it's your college. We have so much pride. My wife and I both have so much pride in going to the University of Iowa, and win, lose, or draw, we're gonna always be a Hawkeye. So we're always proud.
So now you understand what the Purple fans feel like when you guys lose a game at the end or something.
Yeah, and we definitely feel that now. We don't want to be in that situation again as a Viking.
What's the best thing you did on the bye week?
Really just spend time with my family. You know, that's really the best thing. You know, we were able to do a lot of stuff together and get to see my kids and get them, take them to school and pick them up and do all those fun things that you kind of miss out on. But at the same time, you know, really reflect on what we've done through the first 9 weeks and then know what we have to do.
In some way, 4-5 is not perfect, but 4-5, it could have been a lot worse considering everything, the injuries, the Adrian thing, everything that you guys went through this year.
Yeah, we had some distractions, obviously some injuries, but you know, every team really in the league goes through something, you know, especially in the injury bug. I mean, everybody for the most part has lost a big player just you know, due to the game. You know, the game in general is going to take a few guys just based off injury. So, you know, it's something you got to work through and push through. I think we did a good job of finishing, you know, before the bye, obviously. But that in no way just sets us up for these next 7 games. I mean, we have to take it one at a time, and every week stands on its own merits, you know, win, lose, or draw. So we have a frustrated Chicago team, you know, that we're going to go to their place, that we haven't had a good history of winning there, and we need to overcome that.
How much in the locker room does Adrian Peterson come up now that it looks like something could be decided here in the next week or so?
You know, we obviously haven't talked about much, to be honest. We just try to do our job and continue to work on the things we need to work on. I mean, that's all that situation is going to take care of itself. I think the biggest thing for us is just to understand that to let him handle it and let our organization handle it, and we'll fit in where we need to.
I see a big leather couch behind us here. Do you spend a little couch time? I mean, you got a week away from football?
A little bit, not as much as I probably would have liked, but it was nice to get away and just think about other stuff and take care of things that my wife's been badgering me to do for a long time. So I took care of a lot of those honeydew lists.
And the body? The body, does that week off really help your body?
Yeah, you know, for me, you know, having missed those 3 games because of the breaks I had, certainly I wasn't as in dire need as some of the guys. You know, some of these guys are playing, you know, so many snaps, you know, for the first 9 weeks, and they needed a break, you know, more than anybody. So glad they got it, but yeah, definitely ready to go.
You guys have Chicago on Sunday. After seeing what happened on Sunday night, is it important to kind of smack them in the face early to put doubt in their mind?
Well, we need to go out and play our game, and we need to start fast. You know, last week we didn't start fast in our win, but we need to know. We know going on the road, we need to play well from the start because they're going to be coming out ready to roar and to go, and we need to put doubt in their mind, and we need to create that doubt by making plays. And that's, you know, any team in the NFL, I don't care what they had done or what record they have, can beat you. And if you don't come ready to play, especially on the road at their place, so we need to just go in there with a chip on our shoulder, and from the first snap, just be able to do the things that we need to do.
How much self-evaluation do you do? You look at film and just say, all right, this is where I got to get better.
I mean, it's really the end all. I mean, that's all we do. You know, you might look through a game and play an incredible game, but you're always going to remember the 5 mistakes you made, the missed tackles you had, or the missed alignments, the missed opportunities. You know, you look back at those and just you wish you could have had them back, and know when you put in that position again, you're going to correct them and make it right, and mentally kind of go over those situations in your head and just try to make them right, you know, the next time you go out there. So, you know, really, as an athlete, you have to be self-corrective like that and just continue to push forward and try to get better.
Do you have to be careful not to beat yourself up too much?
Well, you know, there's a lot of negativity. You know, criticism is the name of the game. You know, I don't care if you're talking, you know, in the coaching room after a game or talking to the media after a loss. Or, I mean, you know, everybody wants an explanation. And sometimes when you're so hard on yourself, it can be hard to get positive again, get the confidence going. But that's how you rely on your teammates and the guys. You know, the understanding that everybody makes mistakes. You know, we watch the film together, and we know that, you know, we're out there giving everything we got every snap and have each other's back. So, you know, I make a mistake, they're going to pick me up, you know. Brian Robinson makes a mistake, we're going to pick him up. You know, you have that mentality, and you really lean on those guys to get your confidence back and to keep pushing forward.
What about social media? Do you just stay away from it, or what's your philosophy on that?
Yeah, I stay away from it, absolutely. You know, I just there's so many pitfalls that can befall you. You just want to stay away. And with this day and age of everybody having an opinion about sports in general, but just, you know, in society, you know, politics, religion, it's just one of those things that it's okay for everybody to have an opinion, but I don't need to hear everybody's opinion, or, you know, and anybody for that matter. So I don't call my mom after a loss. I don't need her opinion either. So but it's one of those things. You I stay in my lane. I take care of my family first and foremost, and come to work because this is what I do. It's not who I am.
Did you know Orlando Thomas at all? Have any run-ins with Orlando?
I had met Orlando once before. Yeah, and I heard of his passing, and certainly just such a situation that's just, you know, just incredible struggle, you know, and so young to have gone through that, and, you know, to be from being a premier, one of the best athletes in the world, to having that disease just ravage his body, just such a terrible thing to hear. And you know, obviously thoughts and prayers go out to his family and, you know, within our Vikings organization, you know, such a key player in this organization and such a great guy. So, bad loss for us.